If I'm going to go to an event and I want to meet people, I really want to stand out. I mean, thank goodness I'm 5'10 and 150 pounds, so I already stand out.
Yes, you do.
I'm Krista Parkinson, and you're listening to the My Grads Get Jobs podcast, where I talk to entertainment industry professionals about what they do, how they do it, and how my grads can do it too. Season 2 is proudly brought to you by Variety Business Intelligence, home of Variety Insight, VScore, and the Variety Archives. If you're looking to work in Hollywood, Variety Insight is absolutely essential. I depend on it every day to provide me with the most up-to-date listings of contacts, companies, and projects in development. Head to mygradsgetjobs.com/variety to learn more and take advantage of their very generous student rates. Recently, I had the great pleasure of being interviewed on KFI by two-time Emmy Award-winning reporter Elizabeth Espinosa, who also hosts her own podcast, Elizabeth on Top. Elizabeth and I ended up discussing many of the finer points of how to land a job in Hollywood and launch a career. After listening back to my interview with Elizabeth, I felt absolutely compelled to share it. So relax, sit back, and enjoy my super informative conversation with the super fab Elizabeth Espinosa.
I was really excited to get a friend of mine, actually, who has been in the entertainment business for a very long time. She's a former William Morris talent agent, and she now helps 20-somethings get their first jobs in entertainment. And she has founded this company called MyGradsGetJobs.com. I mean, she's incredible. I know she's given me advice in the past and was so laser beam focused, and you walked out of there feeling empowered and really tips that you can't get in school. It comes with experience, and she has a special way of doing it. And she also has this really cool email blast that goes out with only people in the business know about job postings, not something you're going to get anywhere. And also internships, which is really important if you're in college or maybe your child or someone in the family, right, would benefit from this. She also writes for the Huffington Post and gives great job advice, and also has some events that come up, webinars, very techie savvy. She's an adjunct professor also at USC. So Krista Parkinson, thank you for coming back. We really appreciate you.
Thank you for having me back. This is exciting.
Well, and I love the fact that you are the girl who basically landed Mark Cuban, a billionaire, thank you very much, a job.
I didn't get Mark Cuban a job when I was an agent. What happened was I was working for one of his entertainment finance companies that he invested in. And so as a marketing opportunity, we saw an opportunity to get him a guest starring role on Entourage. So one episode of Entourage turned into, I think, 5 episodes of Entourage, and he was on the movie, and we see him on Shark Tank. So that's how it all happened. But yes, Mark didn't call and get it himself. I did.
You did it for him.
Lovely guy.
How do you break the ice? Because there's a picture you should post, and I think you will, or I'm going to post it. You're in a red dress, and to your left is former President Obama and Michelle Obama on the edge, and then to your right, media titan Oprah Winfrey. And you are in the middle, and I'm thinking, how did you get them to pose on the edges and you're in the middle?
What first used to come to mind when I think about networking, I think of, you know, guys in cheap business suits, awkwardly shaking hands and exchanging business cards. But that's not what networking is. Networking is really the art of making meaningful connections. It's not a one-time event. It takes time to really learn and develop. Yes, I am in that red dress, and it actually is one of my networking tips. You know, so often you go to these Hollywood events and everybody's in black pants, black shirts, black dresses. I'm going to go counter to that, and I'm going to show up in red. And I take my cue from Oprah. Many years ago, she had, you know, a black and white ball, and Oprah showed up in red. Why? Because she was the queen of that whole event. If I'm going to go to an event and I want to meet people, I really want to stand out. I mean, thank goodness I'm 5'10 and 150 pounds, so I already stand out.
Yes, you do.
But I will wear high heels and I'll wear a bright red dress. And that's definitely one of the networking tips I have, is to own your femininity. So often we hear, you know, women don't get paid enough and we don't have the equal rights. And I am so sick of that conversation. We need to change the narrative. And the narrative is really own your femininity. We have an innate power to walk into a room and use our femininity, our warmth, our smile, the fact that we can dress differently. We can wear a skirt or a dress or wear feathers in our hair if we want. It's totally acceptable. Men don't have those same luxuries. No, you don't have those options.
The power of the red dress. So the top 5.
We touched on this last time about a business card. You know, you go to a cocktail party or a networking event where you want to do business, and the person who is not in power needs to get a business card from somebody else. So when it comes to business cards, it's better to receive than to give. For example, if I'm in an event and I'm looking for a job and I meet somebody who, you know, maybe I want to be a costume designer and I meet a costume designer at an event. The onus is on me to get her information, to find out how she does it or if there are any job opportunities. So if I receive her business card, I receive the power to follow up.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, you receive the power to follow up. That's true. You know what I tell a lot of students I've mentored over the years? It's not necessarily the exchange of a card. It's how you make them feel. So you have to make sure that you're memorable in some way or form.
That's actually another tip that I have for networking is we've been given two ears and one mouth. We should use them in that ratio.
Mm.
Listen more than you talk. Nobody wants to be with a big talker at a party, you know?
That's hard for me.
If I'm an introvert and I'm a little shyer, I would find somebody like you at a party because clearly you're not shy. You'll take the lead. If you don't listen, you're not going to know what to bounce back at somebody.
I think also being interested in what the other person has to say.
Well, you have to lead with a natural curiosity.
Yes.
If you're not naturally interested and you're just asking questions for the sake of asking questions, that's kind of annoying.
And it's transparent more than you think.
It's totally transparent. I mean, you feel someone's energy more than you hear their words.
Ellen DeGeneres, I mean, you've had at least, what, 9 of your graduates?
Well, 9 in the MyGrads community have been, have worked on the Ellen Show, mostly internships. And it's really interesting because every one of my kids who comes from there says that their lives have been changed. It's not just a job for them. Literally, their lives have been changed in a really positive way.
They've seen
what's possible. I hope to be posting again for the Ellen Show when they're looking for interns. I've got subscribers from all over the country now. And so what originally started out as my little class of 30 students at USC has turned into this website now. And I've got students from Syracuse and Northwestern and, you know, Wisconsin and Chicago and all over the country. Well, shouldn't they get a shot at a show like this? And the answer is yes, they should. But I don't know them yet just from a traditional resume. So I've partnered with a company called dreamjobbing.com. And dreamjobbing is a video platform for you to upload I call them video selfies.
So I love that.
So you basically put together a short video. It can be no more than 60 seconds that tells me about yourself. So if you go to dreamjobbing.com/mygradsgetjobs, you will see my page on there. So I curate potential candidates for all different types of shows and jobs opportunities, whether it's at a talent agency, a TV show, a film, all kinds of things. But I want to know who my subscribers are. And this is a way to do it.
That's fantastic. Well, it's so creative. With the World Wide Web, come on. Now you don't have to physically be in Los Angeles.
Well, speaking of not being physically in Los Angeles, I'm taking my classes outside the classroom. And I'm doing these online video workshops now. So it's like a video conference. Class size is limited. So I'll be setting up workshops to get you prepared for the job market or an internship. I'm going to do a workshop, a 90-minute workshop on resumes, how to network, defining who you are to fit the job you want, interviewing skills. There are going to be a lot of topics out. But again, they'll be listed on my website for the coming months.
But Krista, again, what sets you apart? I mean, what sets you apart in the spaces that you have worked with so many of the top entertainment leaders?
Well, think about it. So a talent agency is nothing but an employment agency for creative people.
Right.
At its minimum. And so I've taken that same skill set of getting jobs for creative people to helping 20-somethings get jobs. So I'm interested in the junior, the senior, the recent college graduate who is looking for their entry-level job. And an entry-level job is an assistant at a talent agency. It's a production assistant. It's an intern. It's a receptionist, maybe at a company. And it's not limited to just creative positions. I work with people who are interested in entertainment finance. I've got my grads working for one of the number one forensic accountants here in Hollywood.
So what's your advice when someone's in, once you get in the door, and maybe you're just a receptionist, you're just an intern?
The biggest advice I would have is just do your job at hand. So when you're the receptionist, be really good at answering the phone. Be really good at greeting people. Make people feel important when they are in the reception area. Get to know them a little bit. Say hi. You know, that's really going the extra mile. If you're a writer and you're a receptionist, nobody cares about the script you've written, you have in your car. Don't push that on other people. When you're really good at being the receptionist, people will want to know you and they'll start to count on you. And then you go, as you get to know them, then you can say, oh, well, yeah, I'm also a writer. Oh, I wrote a pilot script. Oh, you wouldn't mind reading it? Oh, thank you. And that will naturally transpire, but only if you're good at your specific job.
What was it like working with my colleague here, Ryan Seacrest?
It's been absolutely years, but I have to say nothing but positivity for him. He's incredible and he's so nice. You know, as a matter of fact, when I left William Morris, apparently he talked about me on the radio. I didn't even know about it, but he said something really nice, and I really appreciated it. He was amazing because, especially in his early years, I mean, he said yes to everything. Ooh. He was happy. He was easy to work with. People loved working with him. I'd like to reach out and talk to him again. I haven't seen him in many years.
Well, let me ask you this. What about the old Hollywood, you know, adage of fake it till you make it?
I think it's a lie. Why are you going to fake anything? Be who you are. What's wrong with being 20 and not knowing certain things? Who expects you to know anything? You want to fake being a CEO? You want to fake being a showrunner? I think that's dumb. Be who you are.
I think that's so great. Okay, so you have your top five.
Okay, so we've got the red dress. We've got the business card. We've got
Red dress is stand out, basically.
Stand out.
You know, in terms of your attire, dress for the part. Number two was?
It's better to receive than give a business card.
Meaning you want to make sure it's meaningful.
We talked about two ears, one mouth.
Okay, so you got to listen.
Listen and be curious. Listen.
And then number four, number five.
We have to talk about alcohol. When you're at a social situation, when it comes to alcohol, it's one and done. Or better yet, have none. You're young, and there's no reason why you should be whooping it up with these people. These are people you want to have in a professional setting. They are friendly. They are not your friends.
And number five.
You know, if you don't know anybody and you're the only person at a party, how do you get to know somebody? Scan the room. Look for the person who doesn't belong and approach that person.
Right.
Because that person's going to be really happy that somebody's talking to them. You're not going to get rejected. And you can make a friend with somebody who's also going to an event alone, and you can get to know more people that way.
Very important. And you know what? Everyone needs help landing a job. These are skills that anyone and everyone can use. So if you want more information, you can hit up Krista Parkinson at MyGradsGetJobs.com and also email you directly, right?
Right, at Krista@MyGradsGetJobs.com. And if you go on my website, there's a little green button that says subscribe. And also, please keep checking for workshop information.
That's awesome. I'm subscribing. And I'm going to post that picture with you at Oprah and Michelle Obama. So fun. Krista Parkinson, thank you so much.
Thank you. This was so much fun. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Off you go with your Paramount Pictures executives and all these other big time Hollywood folks.
Yeah, and you know that I know that Paramount executive because of you, Miss Elizabeth Espinosa. We're all connectors and networkers.
We really are.
You know, because again, there are always opportunities to network. I was with you and you introduced me to one of the big head honchos of Paramount.
Well,
a wonderful woman.
That's how we roll, sister.
I hope you enjoyed this episode. Feel free to drop me a line or leave a review on iTunes. I'd love to hear from you. That's it for this week. I'll see you on the next episode of the My Grads Get Jobs podcast.